I told you, I emailed you about the issue with lead and baby bottles. And I wanted to ask you what your thoughts are on that. The fact that, and here's an example. I've got, I don't, this isn't a baby bottle, but this is a milk bottle and it's painted with high lead paint. And this is another milk bottle painted with high lead paint. And the baby bottles are painted with the same high lead paint that the milk bottles are painted with. Not all of them, but a lot of them. And it's considered a regulatory loophole where it's not a concern and the CPSC is not doing anything. But I just wanted to get your thoughts on that.
Yeah, I mean, I don't even know what the thought, it's unbelievable to me that there's still lead in any kind of paint of any sort, that especially that has to do with, consumable goods, things that we're, eating and drinking. This is like one of these things that should be a done deal by now. Like the lead paint, for anything, like we're not painting things in lead, not lint milk bottles, not baby bottles, not houses. Like we should just be done painting things in lead. That lead should be out of all the paint. That should be a done deal. There shouldn't be any loopholes. And I don't know why anybody would be advocating for a loophole like that to exist. And the fact that in this day and age, you can still go out and get a milk bottle. And we had a dairy for a while. We probably had milk. We probably had lead on our milk bottles. And we didn't know it any more than the average person did. And I know about lead. Like, where's the loophole? Like, who's fighting for the lead to be in that paint? I want to know who that person is and how they sleep at night.